Hey there, Alpha Maniac Toby here, and welcome back to another tutorial module, where today we'll be going to discuss about the same Android Studio. I know it's been a long time since I've made a video because I was on a trip, and today I have started and I've done this video for you to know what is an emulator in this Android Studio. An emulator is where you run your own app on an Android device which has every facility as like your own phone. You can put it out in your own PC, you can put it out in your own laptop. It's just like a BlueStacks. It's just like BlueStacks, where you can use all of your apps and etc. So how do you make an emulator? Actually, for my PC, the emulator is not supported because my RAM doesn't support it. So for I use my phone, my own Android phone, as an emulator. Let's see what an emulator means. Emulator is also known as an AVD, which is known as an Android Virtual Device. It is your virtual device which you use to run your apps. So I have two emulators which do not work and which do not support my my CPU doesn't support VTX. So most of you have good computers and all, so they may support VTX. So that is why what I use is my own phone, which I can use for doing all my apps. So let's see how this gives out. So your virtual devices, I will just delete all of these. So when you come over here, you can see virtual devices allow you to test your application without having to own the physical devices. Actually, you don't have a physical device like Android, you use iPhone. You can't sync your iPhone to this and run your app. So this provides you to run the app here itself. So let's start and create my own virtual device. So you here, we start off by using your phone, tablet, phone, where that is the watch, and TV. So we always go with phone because the phones are good and all. Nexus 1, which is smaller, Nexus 6, which is tall. I'll go for the 5-inch one, which is new device one, that is better. And you can go here to edit your device. So here you can edit your device like phone or tablet. Screen size is 5 inches, resolution round, I don't know what this, useful for wear devices which are okay. Memory and RAM. So RAM, you can, if you are okay, one, no, let's put it 500 MB, and that is the best thing you can ever do. 500 MB is really good because your RAM will support 500 MB and it'll be faster for you. Input, these device has, these has hardware, keyboard, no problem. Proported, okay. No idea of cameras, by the way. And finish this. Okay. So let's go to the next. So here I have Marshmallow. You can put anything here. See here, there is a download buttons. So if you want for your lollipop, you can download it. Nougat, you can download it, etc. So I'm gonna go with this and say next. So I can name my device. I'm gonna name it Alpha 11, and this, so everything, orientation and everything. So let's go to advanced settings and see here our latency and etc. Graphics, auto, multi-core CPU, experimental, etc, etc. See, you can choose here a hardware or software. Use your hardware computer graphics for faster. Software, emulate the graphics in the software to work around. Auto, let the emulator decide. So we have to keep it in auto, that is really good. RAM, heat, internal storage, let's put internal storage 800 MB, okay. SD card, okay. Okay. Finish. Now your AVD will be saved, and whenever you start off making an app, like I have just created here a small app, and when you start, when you click the button play here, it will directly go to your AVD. Or if you put up the phone, if you troubleshoot, if you correct your USB with your phone, it will directly take it to the AVD. Actually, using a virtual device is really good, because hence you can see how you can how your app runs on, etc. Here you can't run your app, this is just how your app looks, and in that you can see how your app will be like. So let's see this Android virtual device. My AVD is saving. Just close this down. So guys, I know this has been a long time since I have made videos. You guys have been waiting for me to do videos. Thanks for all the support you have been giving me. I'm telling this daily because you guys are really great. Look at these 43 subscribers. I really appreciate you giving me subscribes and 72 views. But you guys have not put any comments, really problem and etc. So I'm looking forward that you guys, you know, you could just give me suggestions about how to do this and that. That would be perfect. Because there be something there, because you and me would be we would have a good interface between us. So we are back here, and you can see that my Android virtual device is created. But when I start to play this, it shows that I can't run this because it has a problem for my CPU. So what I say is, you guys have better computers than mine. You guys have better PCs, laptops than mine. You guys have better phones than mine. So you can use this like a physical device. That is, you can put a USB on your own Android phone and test out your app using your phone. So when you start doing that, you'll get to know more experiments about this. And I tell you something, that please consider doing more experiments and comments in my videos. You could also do experiments with these, like how I have done here, to get more results, etc., etc. So what I say is, this is a short module for creating your own emulator. Later on, I'll be telling you how to add two numbers, or how to code two numbers to get added in this and make a small app. That is what project is here. I'll show you that in a jiffy. Thank you guys for all the support. Please consider subscribing, and thanks a lot. And let's see in the next video. Until then, goodbye.